Now the floor is for His Excellency Mr. Evo Morales Ayiwa, President of the Plurinational State of Bolivia. Your Excellency, the floor is yours. Thank you.
Muchas gracias.
Thank you very much.
Hermano presidente de 62
My brother, President of this 62nd session.
Hermanas ministras, hermanos ministros.
Ministers and
hermanas y hermanos
representatives of the various diplomatic missions.
En primer lugar,
first of all, I wish to warmly thank you for inviting me to participate in this 62nd session of the United Nations Commission on Narcotic Drugs.
Es importante recordar
it is important that we recall that 10 years have already passed since the political declaration and the plan of action that were adopted in the year 2009 to serve as a strategy in order to tackle the world drugs problem. And if we were to carry out an assessment, we could identify some progress, but we would also have to note that there are still many challenges unmet. Reality has shown us that the so-called war on drugs has failed. And now we are compelled to conceive of new models recognizing the reality of each and every one of our countries and their experiences. In this context, I would therefore like to share with you our experience in Bolivia.
De nuestro modelo de lucha contra el narcotráfico y el control social a la producción de la hoja de coca.
And exercising control
cuando llegamos
over coca
al gobierno,
production. When our government entered into force, we inherited a model that was very far from Bolivian reality, a model that failed to take into account the cultural, traditional, and medicinal uses of coca leaves. Quite the contrary, the coca leaf was stigmatized and criminalized. The anti-drugs policy that was implemented during neoliberal times in Bolivia was geared towards punishing coca producers, and in turn became a mechanism to serve geopolitical control. The eradication of coca production was forced in nature and failed to respect human rights. In the same vein, alternative development was promoted as a substitution for coca production, which was attached to the total eradication of our coca through a zero coca policy. The criminalization of coca production and the imposition of policies that were very far from our reality led to an economic, social, and cultural crisis affecting the coca producers and the Bolivian people. And therefore, in Bolivia, we decided to develop our own model to combat drugs trafficking, and therefore were able to implement a coordinated mechanism to reduce surplus coca leaf production, flanked by comprehensive development of coca as a cultural matter and a matter of identity. Brothers and sisters, I want you to know that the anti-drugs policy was imposed upon us by the United States. You will recall that Law 1008 in Bolivia to combat drugs trafficking was submitted to our national parliament in English. Similarly, all such decisions showed direct interference with a clear and marked presence of the DEA. At many times in our political history in Bolivia, this had an impact on our internal policy decisions. It was the United States who decided who would be appointed as commander of the police, who would be responsible for leading these special anti-drugs task forces. The DEA and the military bases that the United States erected in Bolivia in order to ensure control led to deaths, injuries, and disappearances. They appeared to be the true masters of Bolivia. By way of example, let me point out that in 2004, These acts of social repression continued to such an extent that there were confrontations that led to the deaths of coca growers.
Este hecho,
and it was this act that led the federations of Cochabamba to issue the social request of a specific amount of coca
per family,
a so-called cattle. One cattle is the equivalent of 1.6
desde que asumimos square meters
for the region of Cochabamba,
y diseñar de manera and this respected the traditional area that had been set aside
for peace in the Yungas. Since I assumed the presidency in Bolivia, we have decided to nationalize
de la nueva constitución política del Estado, these decisions and ensure that we can uphold our
anti-drugs policy in a true, dignified, and sovereign manner. In 2013, we were able to set aside, as a result of a reservation to the 1961 Vienna Convention, decriminalizing acunicu, or coca leaf chewing, in Bolivia. And in the same time, we firmly uphold the prohibition on the use of glyphosate for coca eradication, as we are well aware of the terrible consequences that this has
terribles consecuencias para la madre for Mother Earth y para el medio ambiente.
And for the environment.
Quiero que sepa, hermanas y hermanos,
brothers
que
and sisters, I would like you to know
that del
at no time has Bolivia in any way strayed from international law. Rather, we have followed the procedures set forth under the 1961 Convention and under treaty law.
As regards coca production and control, se han establecido mecanismos de control social
been
donde se aplica el diálogo, la concertación, coordination y el respeto a los derechos humanos con los sindicatos y comunidades para la toma de decisiones. Asimismo, se han implementado mecanismos de sanción para quienes tienen coca excedentaria. Existe un autocontrol de los mismos productores.
And the producers themselves are responsible
algo
for exercising control.
Es que nuestro modelo
a further
se
important
centra en la
point
familia.
To note is that our model
estamos
is based on the family.
Hemos
we are proud of what we have achieved to date, and we are grateful for the international recognition that our work has received from various international entities.
Hace 13 años, 13 la producción de coca ago, en Bolivia
production
representaba
in Bolivia
el 20% del total de cultivos
of the
de coca
total
en la región
amount of coca leaf
hoy,
production in the Andean region.
Currently, el 10% total
our
de
output
cultivos.
Only represents 10% of this total output.
Eso demuestra el éxito de la aplicación de nuestro modelo.
And this attests to the successful implementation of our model.
También es importante
it is equally important,
importante no
to bear in mind
vista
that drugs trafficking exists because there is a demand for these drugs.
Hermanas y hermanos,
and brothers and sisters, there are countries such as the United States and others that are leaders when it comes to drug use, and therefore, at this meeting, we should also engage in studying whether the actions adopted to prevent drug use are proving effective and what needs and what should be done in order to improve them.
Hermanas y hermanos, representantes,
brothers and sisters, representatives,
como señalé hace 10 años
as I said
atrás,
already 10 years ago, and
mantengo,
as I continue to sustain,
no puede existir el libre cultivo de coca,
you cannot have free cultivation of coca production. But at the same time,
existe en Bolivia y otros países hermanos,
zero coca leaf production
el uso y consumo
is equally unfeasible
y medicinal.
Because in Bolivia
hoy
and in
Bolivia,
other brotherly countries,
con el apoyo
we have the traditional, ancestral, and medicinal use
y universidades
of coca.
Destacadas,
here in Bolivia, with the support of the World Health Organization and renowned universities, studies are being undertaken in order to show that the coca leaf does not affect human health negatively, and quite the contrary, in fact, has medicinal and nutritional value. Therefore, I would like to share the following with you, the positive experience that we have developed based on our model. Through the regionalization of the struggle against drugs trafficking, by establishing a regional anti-drugs intelligence gathering center in Bolivia,
Serian,
known as Serian,
donde los países de la región, Brasil, Argentina,
we
Paraguay,
have brought together countries of the region, Brazil, Argentina, and Paraguay, who have sent their liaison officers and their intelligence analysts to work in unison and in a coordinated fashion.
A la fecha hemos logrado importantes resultados,
varios significant results. We have been able to capture a number of individuals who were,
asimismo,
on the run and were the subject of international arrest warrants for drugs trafficking.
Una nueva legislación
in Bolivia, we have also recently adopted a new set of legislation that comprises effective mechanisms to strengthen our struggle against drug trafficking, such as efficient cooperation,
interceptación,
wiretapping,
telecomunicaciones, pago
paying informers,
de informantes, la extinción de dominio,
and forfeiture of assets.
Con estas medidas,
through these measures,
se establecerá
we have been
para
able to further strengthen our approach in order to dismantle criminal organizations and strike them economically
el
where
consumo
it hurts.
Y el tráfico de drogas
drug use and drugs trafficking
unos 300,
move approximately some $320 billion yearly.
Y ese dinero
and this money is moved using illegal mechanisms between the banks.
Y a través de los bancos.
And for this reason,
por eso condenamos todo
we
tipo
condemn
de paraísos fiscales,
all forms of tax havens
y reivindicamos
and
la importancia de la transparencia
stress the
de las cuentas de
for
todas
transparency
las personas.
And openness of accounts
en
of all individuals.
Toda la autoridad del
in
gobierno
Bolivia, all government
hemos
authorities
hecho pública nuestras cuentas
have
bancarias.
Disclosed their bank accounts.
Y mantendremos nuestra
once again, we reiterate our call
a emprender acciones
for the need for tangible actions in order to put an end to these tax havens and thus undermine drugs trafficking and weaken transnational organized crime.
Para concluir,
to conclude,
quiero saludar y agradecer
I would like to commend
el acompañamiento
and to thank
de la Unión
the European Union
en el
for
marco
its support
de su responsabilidad compartida, a través de un marco de cooperación respetuoso, dialogado
and
y lo más importante,
respectful responsibility, free from conditions,
de igual manera,
which is most important. And in the same vein, I would also like to thank the United Nations Office Against Drugs and Crime
in Bolivia que acompaña la
implementación
de la política antidroga boliviana
of our Bolivian anti-drugs policy, helping to buttress our institutional capacity in order to tackle organized crime.
Nuestro modelo de lucha contra el narcotráfico,
our model to combat drugs trafficking
con control social,
through the exercise of social control
a los derechos humanos,
which respects human rights
con coca,
and through the comprehensive development of coca has gained visibility on the international level
and
therefore
exitosa.
Our
Muchas
anti-drugs
gracias.
Policy is successful. Thank you very much.